Water quality describes as the conditions of the water, including chemical, physical, and biological characteristics, usually with respect to its suitability for a particular purpose. However, in this lesson, we will focus on water quality for larval rearing. Artificial propagation involves human interventions, and since larval rearing ideally involving complete control over the environmental parameters, which is common in intensive aquaculture. Water quality parameters must be always be a concern and constantly monitored to prevent poor water quality affecting the development process during larval rearing. Since my group mates already discussed some related topics on environmental parameters, in this video we'll be focused on water quality parameters that really needs more attention to ensure the development process doesn't compromise. The water quality parameters that we will be discussing is for both species and gilthead sea bream as our example. These are water temperature, salinity, dissolved oxygen, water flow, the inlet and outlet, and other related topics. With water temperature. Water temperature is critical because it is the most important quality in environmental parameters. Temperature influences water chemistry. Like for an example, cold water can hold more dissolved oxygen than warm water. In winter, early spring, when the water temperature is low, the dissolved oxygen concentration is high. In summer and fall, when water temperature is high, the dissolved oxygen concentration is often lower. For gilthead sea breams and sea bass, spawning temperatures at incubations up to yolk sac absorptions slowly increasing 0.5 degrees Celsius per day to reach 18 to 20 degrees Celsius, but both species requires fluctuations should never exceed 0.5 degrees Celsius in within 24 hours. The next one is salinity. It is the amount of salt dissolves in a body of water. Saline water. Salinity plays a critical role on egg, embryo, and larval development during life cycle. For both species, they have the same salinity at spawning, about 35 to 38 ppt, full seawater. A lower salinity down to 25 to 30 ppt during first feeding may enhance survival rate. Maintaining the minimum level of salinity during this process also increases survival rate. Another important parameter that we need to observe is dissolved oxygen. Oxygen is provided to fish through the water renewal and to a limited extent, at least in a larval rearing, through aeration. Since renewal rates during the first stage of larval culture are rather low, it is important to monitor dissolved oxygen content and to adjust it whenever it falls below 80% saturation. For both species, they require DO or dissolved oxygen must be a minimum of 80% and a maximum of 100%. One common practice to maintain DO content and adjust artificially to minimum or maximum level, aeration is one of the options, especially in intensive aquaculture productions. This technique is commonly used in aquaculture to address low oxygen level to their ponds and tanks. Another water parameter must be constantly checked is the level of pH. This indicates hydrogen ions in the water. If it is too high, or so-called alkaline, or too low is acidic. Changes in the way that stresses fish can cause serious problems, in which generally affects the development process of your larva. The level of pH in the water must be not alkaline nor acidic to maintain or increase the survival rate of your larvae. Phosphate and nitrate from fertilizers promotes growth of excessive levels, can lead to eutrophications and fish kills, and reductions in biodiversity. Eutrophication is the result of algae blooms, which also a stressor contributor. That is why we need to have a water quality check daily. One is to maintain water flow, which inlet and outlet of water, to allow new water and replacing used water during larval rearing, which one preparation of next stage for development. The water flow inlet has to be placed carefully in order to avoid dangerous strong currents that can trigger spinal deformities and impede the onset of predatory behavior. Inlet should be at the tank periphery and positions in a way that would avoid tangential currents. Generally, inlets are built to control and the amount of water flowing into the funnels or tanks. Outlet, on the other hand, is to cap the water surface in the fund at its optimum level, to allow for the complete draining of the fund and harvesting the fish when necessary.